about all the mast high, when the mermen win their day. The doughty Douglas bowed him to ride into England to drive a prey. He chose the Gordons and the Grahams, the Lindsays light and gay. But the Jardines would not with him ride, and they rue it to this day. Oh, he has burned the dales of Tyne and part of Bamborough-shire, and three good towers on the Redwyre fells he's left them all on fire. And he has marched up to Newcastle and rode it round the mouth. Oh, was the lord of this castle, and was the lady old? Oh, but up and spake proud Lord Percy, and oh, but he spoke high. Oh, I am the lord of this castle, and me wife is a lady gay. Oh, if thou art the lord of this castle, say well it pleases me. For ere I cross the border fells, the Tain of Oz shall be. He took a long spear in his hand, shod with metal free. And for to meet the Douglas there, he rode right furiously. Oh, but oh, how pale his lady looks, free off the castle wall. When down before the Scottish spear, she saw proud Percy fall. Oh, had twa been upon the green, and never an eye to see, oh, I would ha' had your flesh and fell, but your sword sell gay with me. For the art of burn is a bonny burn, 'tis pleasant there to be. But there is not a totter born to feed my men and me. Oh, the deer in wild on hill and dale, the birds fly wild from tree to tree. Oh, but there is neither bread nor kale to feed my men and me. Yet I will stay at Otterbourne, where ye shall welcome be. And if ye come not there 3 days, and a false lord I'll call thee. Oh, thither will I come, proud Percy said, by the might of our lady. There will I bide thee, said Douglas, my troth I plight to thee. They lighted high on Otterbourne, upon the Bensay Brown. They lighted high on Otterbourne, and threw their pallions down. And he that had a bonny boy sent out his horse to grass. And he that had not a bonny boy, his ain servant he was. But when them spake a little page before the peep of dawn, oh, waken, waken ye, my good lord, for Percy's hard at hand. Oh, ye lie, ye lie, ye liar low, so loud I hear ye lie. For Percy had not none yestere'en to dight my men and me. Oh, but I have dreamed a dreary dream beyond the island of Skye. I saw a dead man win a fight, and I think that man was I. He's belted on his good bred sword, and to the field he ran. But he forgot his helmet good, that should have kept his brain. When Percy with a Douglas met, by what he was full fain. They swake their swords till sore they swat, and the blood ran down like rain. But Percy with his good broadsword, that could so sharply wound, has wounded Douglas on the brow, till he fell to the ground. And he's called on his little foot page, and said, run speedily, and fetch my ain dear sister's son, Sir Hugh Montgomery. My nephew good, the Douglas said, what wrecks the death of him? Last night I dreamed a dreary dream, and I ken the days lie in. My wound is deep, and I fain would sleep. Take thou the vanguard of three, and hide me by the bracken bush that grows on yonder lily lee. Oh, bury me by the bracken bush, beneath the burning briar. Let never a living mortal ken that here a kindly Scot lies. He lifted up that noble lord with sought a tear in his eye, and he's hid him in the bracken bush that his merry men not see. Oh, the moon was clear, the day drew near, the spears in Flinders flew. But many a gallant Englishman here day the Scotsman slew. The Gordons good in English blood, they stepped their horse and shone. The Lindsays flew like fire about, till all the fray was done. The Percy and Montgomery met, neither of the other was fain. They swapped swords, they twa swapped, and the blood ran down between. Now yield thee, Percy said, or else I'll lay thee low. To whom must I yield, quoth Earl Percy, now that I see it must be so. Thou shalt not yield to lord or lown, they shalt not yield to me. But yield ye to the bracken bush that grows upon the lily lee. I will not yield to a bracken bush, nor yet will I yield to a briar. Oh, but I would yield to Earl Douglas, or Sir Montgomery if he were here. As soon as he saw it was Montgomery, he struck his sword point in the ground. But Montgomery was a courteous knight, and quickly took him by the hand. The steed was done at Otterbourne at the breaking of the day. Earl Douglas was buried at the bracken bush, and Percy led captive away. Oh, it fell about the Lammas tide, when the mermen went their hame. The doughty Douglas bound him to ride into England to drive a frame. Oh, he chose the Gordons and the Grahams with the Lindsays light and gay. But the Jardines would not with him ride, and they rue it to this day.